Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to It's Rainmaking Time. This is Kim Greenhouse. It gives me great pleasure to bring you Dr. Tullio C. Mancini. He is the author of the book, Cancer is a Fungus, and he has one of the breakthrough solutions for treating cancer. He is an oncologist from Rome, Italy. We've had him on the show one time, but there's so many more questions and discussion points I want to have with him. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome Dr. Tullio C. Mancini to It's Rainmaking Time. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon also to you. I don't know if it is afternoon, but here is almost evening.
I really appreciate you coming back to visit us. You and I, when we did the show last time, you were about to go to Japan to open up a clinic there.
Right.
And I really would like to know what happened with your journey to Japan. Is the clinic set up there? Are any other clinics on the way?
We take a little bit our time because my partners over there wanted to ask for the permission of the Ministry of Health. So it took a little bit longer, but they told me that it would be completely set up within the end of this year, more or less. But it is a big deal because there is the possibility to show definitely that the cancer is a fungus with a big trial, a big experimentation. So my plan is to go there within the end of the year.
There are so many people stricken with cancer, whether it's brain cancer, gallbladder cancer, cancer of the breast, tumors behind the nose. And your methodology, your treatment is to inject a certain percentage of sodium bicarbonate directly into the tumor if you can, and if not, into the artery that feeds into the tumor. Is that correct?
Yes, not always, but it is important to reach the tumor directly. For instance, for the nose, for the epipharynx, for the brain, the best procedure is to locate a port cut into the carotids, external or internal, and then flush inside the sodium bicarbonate solution. For the pleura or the peritoneum, it is more suitable to put a catheter from a simple catheter through the walls of the chest or of the abdomen. For other parts, for other tumors, for instance, for the rectum, prostate, liver, a port cut is always the best solution. For other places, for other sites, other places such as uterus, neck of uterus, or mouth, or stomach, the irrigation, external irrigation can be enough. So, but it depends on the location of the tumor. But it is not a simple thing. Just take orally sodium bicarbonate. This is not effective most of time.
It's really interesting because a lot of people around the world think and assume wrongly that they can just drink sodium bicarbonate and their tumor is going to go away, and that's not true. So let me ask you something. We live at a time where celebrities and people of great wealth have the ability to go anywhere in the world to take any form of treatment they want. Why do people who have the money and the ability to do the research continue to go toward chemotherapy and radiation?
Because there is no information. All the information is in the hands of the official system. So the official system, official oncology says only lies, because scientists, oncologists don't know what is a cancer. They have no solution, so they cannot provide treatments that they don't know where they can be effective. So, but the celebrities have go to the big clinics, big hospitals, big doctors, and unavoidably they go to the massacre, like the humble people.
For example, Michael Douglas had radiation and chemotherapy. The man can barely swallow. He's lost 40 pounds. He can't eat. How is it possible for someone to live if they can't swallow and they can't eat? I don't get it.
Because the cancer, that is the fungal colony, they grow continuously. But when oncologists make terrible treatments like chemo and radiation, they favor cancer, and the fungi can go all over into the body. There is a syndrome, paraneoplastic syndrome, that prevents from any recovery. So the bad condition, metastasis, and impossibility to recover depends most of time on the official treatments. In fact, 9 million people die from cancer, but nobody knows why, and scientists continue to deceive people with the story of the abnormal cellular growth. That is a tale, is a stupidity, like the stupid scientists that build up this strange treatment, this strange, sorry, theory. Is as you can tell people that a person can eat his own hands. It is impossible. So the theory is stupid, and the treatments are stupid. But the treatment are stupid, the conventional treatments are stupid and harmful. The alternative treatments without idea are stupid and stupid. There are a lot of treatments in USA. They give all over, or in Germany, or Australia, and Canada. They give and they administer millions of pills, tablets, supplements, vitamins, waves, all stupidities. For a cancer, it is important to kill the fungus. You cannot build up or reinforce the immune system. We reinforce the immune system. You have to think positive. You have to eat veg, fruits, no sugar, no meat, no. Everything is stupid, because there are the alternative carers that don't understand, don't know anything. Just that they just sell tablets. You understand me? That?
Absolutely, which leaves you in a very unusual position, doing what you're doing and knowing what you know. Because if you look to your left, you have the traditional cancer treatments. If you look to your right, you have the plethora of alternative treatments, but those alternative treatments haven't hit the mark either, for the most part. And so right. You're like in the middle of the whole thing, where you look to the left and you look to the right, and most of those treatments are not working, but people don't want people with cancer to know that.
But if you see, you have in Tijuana, in Mexico, hundreds of clinics of the stupid treatments, hundreds of diets. The diets, Broyes, Bechansky, Kuzmin, Gerson, and other diets, who is Clark, and but if you don't know the subject of your diet or the subject of